Part 2. Azure Moon. Blue Sea Moon. The Impregnable Fortress. When Claude steps down as its leader, the Lester Alliance disbands, and its lords swear fealty to the Holy Kingdom of Fargus. The chaos in the kingdom begins to dissipate as the people unite under Dimitri's rule. Riding this momentum, the Kingdom Army prepares to march south for a decisive battle against Imperial forces.
We will finally have our decisive battle with the Empire this month.
The Eastern Lords are in the process of consolidating all of the troops within the entire kingdom. In addition, ever since Arian Road's liberation, the Western Lords have been declaring their fealty, one after another.
Affairs within the kingdom have calmed down considerably, and we even managed to win over the Alliance.
Although it was a rough go at first, I'm starting to feel like we could actually win this.
That's true. Thinking back on it now, we've really come a long way.
We even have a lead as to where Rhea is located. It is as we predicted all along. If we are to rescue Rhea, then we must defeat the Emperor. If we're going to march from the monastery to Inbar, then we'll have to cross the Great Bridge of Murden again, right?
Yes, I believe so. As we have gained the Alliance's support, we should not have any trouble this time. After the bridge, we can cross Gronder Field and head south. And then we'll take Mercius, the so-called impregnable fortress that towers on the other side.
Fort Mercius, I know of it. They say it rivals even Arian Road.
Count Burgles, the Empire's Minister of Military Affairs, once had troops stationed there. But according to our spies, a large-scale military force has entered the stronghold. Perhaps they are gathering soldiers from various regions to compensate for their losses.
If we try to avoid it, those troops will follow us and attack from the rear. It is best for us to handle the situation head-on. Once we take Fort Mercius, Enbar will be within reach. This is the Empire's last chance to stop us from arriving at our goal.
In other words, if we take this fort, then our blades will be at the Emperor's throat in no time.
If this is the last fort between us and them, then the Emperor will likely do everything she can to strengthen its defenses.
I just received a report on that very subject. The one commanding the troops stationed at Fort Mercius is someone we have crossed blades with many times. It is the Death Knight who awaits us there.
Your Highness, you still have scars on your back. It does you no good to languish in pain. I will procure some medicine.
No, it is fine. Though they are still deep, these are from 9 years ago. They do not hurt any longer. Besides, it would be a shame if the scars I got from protecting you were to fade. I bear these scars proudly. It makes me think that it was worthwhile that someone like me survived.
To hear you say such things.
Dudu, you say that I saved you. But do you know that you also saved me that day? If I had been unable to save anyone, I would have been the sole survivor. I would have had no reason to keep living. But I saved someone. Saved you. That and that alone has always been my crutch.
When I stood before those soldiers and their swords that day, I was prepared to die. But then, you suddenly appeared, and you shielded me. I knew then that a savior's hand could reach into even the deepest darkness. I still have not been able to repay that debt.
Have you not heard a word I've said? You have saved me in countless ways. 5 years ago, I did nothing but await my execution within my jail cell. Was it not you that saved me?
That was nothing more than my duty as your vassal.
Listen, Dudu, perhaps you consider me to be someone special, but I think the same of you. You are irreplaceable, cherished. So stop saying that we cannot be friends. Stop saying such awful things.
Please, do not look at me that way. You promised me you would build a kingdom that is proud to boast of Dusker blood. In this kingdom, where there is no distinction between the people of Dusker and the people of Fodlan, will I finally, without reservation, be able to call you my friend. Will I, Dimitri?
Dudu. Yes, you will call me your friend again and again, no matter how many hardships I must endure.
I will do all I can to bring about that world as well. To be your friend is what I have always wanted.
Is that so? I am glad to hear it.
But until that time, we must allow no harm to befall you. So please call upon me when you walk alone at night. And even when you go out in the day, please tell me where you are going and whom you are meeting.
In the end, I suppose there is no fixing your overprotectiveness, is there? I suppose I can live with that.
Another day, another training session, I see. You're quite dedicated. And practicing with the sword today. You weren't any good with it when you were little, as I recall.
And who told you that?
Lord Rodrigue mentioned it to me. He said you used to swing your sword so hard that you'd break it.
That was ages ago. I've had plenty of time to improve since then. Now I count swordplay as one of my specialties. Care to see for yourself?
Well, I can't just take your word for it, can I? Let's see what you've got. Well, I'm impressed. You're better than I expected.
I could say the same of you. I suppose we students still have much to learn.
No need for false modesty. We fought as equals just now. You're strong, and your form is excellent. You're clearly an experienced fighter. But you're greedy. You can't be so impatient to win. It'll come at a grave cost.
Greedy? I see. I'll take that note to heart. You have my thanks for the instruction.
Ah, it returns. The formality, the stiffness. Anyway, after we're through here, I might head into town for some food. Care to join me?
I appreciate the invitation, but I have certain duties I must attend to this evening.
Of course you do. Never mind about my plans then.
I thought you'd say that. You have the same sense of responsibility as I do.
You think so? I didn't want to push you to join me. We can just do it another day. I'll confess, I'm taking a shine to you. I'd like to talk to you more.
I would like that as well. Ever since I saw you wielding a sword all those years ago, I've been following in your footsteps. To be able to stand with you and cross swords is quite a...
Hey, slow down. Where did all this come from? You're embarrassing me. That's enough chatter for now anyway. Let's get back to sparring. This time with lances. I won't hold back. Show me what you can do.
Right. Prepare yourself.
So sorry.
What is it, Annette?
I completely forgot that it's my turn for kitchen duty today. Huh? Did you do all the kitchen prep already?
Kitchen duty is mine today.
What? But... Oh, did I get the day wrong?
Yes. Yours is tomorrow.
Oh. I'm so sorry. Wow, I really am something else.
These things happen. Is something funny?
Oh, no. I was just happy. So, you probably already know this, but my uncle is really strict. He wanted me to be perfect at cooking, studying, cleaning, washing, everything, really. He said... If I wasn't perfect, as a knight's daughter, I'd be devaluing my crest. Whenever I messed up, he looked so mad. And he'd sigh like he just lost his faith in humanity.
That is harsh.
Oh, I know he loved me and all. He was just kind of scary. But you've helped me out and been patient with me without getting mad. I'm just so happy. Thank you, Dudu.
I have hardly done anything.
You know what? You remind me of my father.
Of Gilbert.
You look scary at first glance, but you're actually really kind.
Is that so?
Oh, right. Let me help you with something, if that's okay with you. What are you cooking today? Hopefully I can chip in.
It is a meat dish from Fargus.
I'm still a complete klutz, so I'm not gonna be in the way, am I?
Not at all. I was hoping that the food I made would bring a smile to your face.
Oh, wow. That's... Well then, I can't wait for dinner time.
Good.
Do you need something? Let's hear it.
Oh, no, I don't need anything. I was just hoping to talk to you, Felix.
When I said you could be near me, I meant on the battlefield. You're pushing it a little too far. You better not start calling me Emil.
You know, I'm not just using you as a stand-in for my brother. I don't mean to upset you. But I've come to realize that you two don't have that much in common after all.
I don't understand. Why are you hanging around me if not to replace your brother?
It's not that I want to be near Emil, but I want to be near you.
What?
How embarrassing. It must sound like I'm coming on to you. Regardless, you've made it clear that you don't want me around.
No. It's not that.
Good. Then I'll continue to spend time at your side.
What a perplexing creature.
What's that? Did you say something? Never mind that. Why don't we go out for a nice cup of tea?
I can't think of a reason to refuse your invitation, so I suppose I have to accept.
So, Felix, is the tea to your liking?
It is.
It's nice to relax like this every now and then, isn't it?
It is.
You said some of your equipment is damaged, didn't you?
It is.
Are you not in the mood to talk? We could discuss your family or what's happening in high society. Flavors of tea? Your favorite jokes?
None of those. I already told you, I don't joke.
Of course, only cynicism. Oh, I know. We're holding a small opera in the cathedral soon. I'll be singing too. If you're interested in... but of course you aren't.
You can sing?
I'm sorry. What did you just say? Can I sing? I was only a diva of the Mittelfranc Opera Company, that's all.
Oh, right. I forgot.
You forgot? Am I that uninteresting to you? What must you think of me?
You're insincere and loud, is what I think. But you do make a good sparring partner. And a good tea companion.
Oh.
Anyway, when's the concert?
It's an opera, and you don't have to come.
You just invited me. You can't tell me not to come. That's for me to decide.
Oh, then you must be there. I'll sing my heart out just for you.
I haven't said I'll go.
Are you going to come or not? If you keep teasing me, I might just pretend to cry.
Fine, I'll go.
Fantastic! I look forward to it.
The Kingdom Army crosses the Great Bridge of Murden a second time, moving south through Gronder Field. However, in order to reach Anbar, they must first seize the impregnable Fort Mercius.
Fort Mercius. Said to rival Arion Road, the Silver Maiden. Perhaps a head-on siege was a foolish plan after all.
No, you're right that it's the only way. I don't think the Death Knight would have fallen for any tricks. Even if they are denied supplies, they could hold a fortress like this for months. And we cannot discount the possibility that they will receive more reinforcements if our siege is delayed.
Yes, my thoughts exactly. And we have no option but to do the best we can. Say, Professor, in the past, it seemed like the Death Knight took some strange satisfaction from his fights with you. He's an unpredictable opponent, a dangerous one. Please proceed with caution. Of course. You were the heart of the Blue Lions, and the same holds true for the Kingdom Army.
Woman approaches.
They broke through the gates. Guess it's time for an impressive counterattack.
How did I get tangled up in all of this?
You are finally here. Will Death's Scythe claim you? Or will I fall to that sword of yours? And Mercedes, here you are as well.
Alright, well, for an impregnable fortress, this looks very impregnable right now, because we're inside already. Oh boy, we're gonna have to deal with... Man, these guys are huge. 95 HP on the first health bar. Holy shit. We have Caspar. And there he is. Level 50. Ooh. Still the same weapon. 42 attack. What are you, Dimitri? 37 speed. Holy shit. That's a lot of speed. Does Lionheart have a meteor or some shit like that? No. Just Nosferatu, wow. They kinda chill on Lionheart. Alright, this doesn't look too bad. A lot of battalions here then. I'm gonna have to be careful.
They broke through the main gate. Trample them. All save that woman.
Even though we smashed the main gate, Fort Mercius is still an ironclad fortress. And the enemy commander is the Death Knight. We must not falter in our assault. I now see why they call this keep impregnable. Everywhere you turn is defensive weaponry. We must capture all of those locations as we push forward. If even one of them takes a shot at you, we will be in trouble.
Oh, don't worry, Dimitri. I have dealt with magic ballistas before.
At your service.
Alright, let's get the strike going.
Thank you.
Hello. How about you die?
Can't afford to slack off.
Oh, we have a chest. Oh, I didn't even notice the chest. Any more chests? Oh boy, well, I guess my character is gonna have to go that way. Unless I trade... Actually, I guess I could trade... chest key with a Hilda. How many chest keys do I have left though? That's a good question. No, I only have two, okay. I can take your free Google, I guess. I don't think you're gonna use it, honestly.
And ready when you are.
Ingrid can probably take the other one.
Leave it to me.
Alright, so how should I approach this? Do we take care of this one or this one first? I guess I'll take care of this guy.
I will prevail.
I am prepared.
Let's make this quick.
Oh wait, what am I in range of? Oh, this guy. Only 5 damage. I will take your 5 damage.
Let's clean up. More fighting.
Actually, I know something I could probably do.
Appreciate
it. Petra. Kill this mage.
No use! Not for myself, for everyone!
They bait this guy to come here. Oh, I'm in range of the ballista though. Okay, maybe that didn't work out as I was hoping. Oh well, whatever.
Onward.
I thought I would have more movement to get out of the range of the ballistas. But oh well. This guy's... oh, this guy can't even hit me. Alright, well, that guy's gonna kill himself then. This guy a bow knight? No.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna take it slow. I'm gonna go one by one, because otherwise this might be... I should have Dimitri bait out these guys. I do need to take care of the ballistas eventually. Actually, I could probably warp somebody next turn. That works.
Fools! Push forward and surround them!
Man, these guys are so big. Oh, they're all gonna move? Are we feeling like that? No, we are feeling like that. Alright, well, the stakes gotta be the higher now. In that case. That. Oh, Gaspar can reach me from there. He has a Brave Axe too, so I probably shouldn't fuck with that. Easy barrier break. Alright, now we just need to kill it. What are you guys' range? Mainly the knights, because I don't really care too much about you. Imperial Guard? Oh god, that looks annoying. Alright, well, Dimitri, have fun. Actually, probably kill this guy.
On my honor.
Take me if you must.
Last but not least, I guess Hilda could probably get the kill.
It's done.
Oh god. That's a lot of HP.
Thanks.
Dude, can you one-shot this guy? Oh, you, of course you can. Wow, 447% crits and not a single crit.
My loyalty.
Gotta love the RNG, right? Alright, meanwhile... I guess I can have Mercedes take care of this guy? Like, Mercedes should take like no damage from this dude. Banshee. Reduce movement plus for one turn. I guess the Ballista is really the only dangerous thing here. And you know what? I will wait, I guess. Because my card is definitely getting Gambit. 20%. Miss. Oh, he doesn't even explode if it misses. That's hilarious.
Worrisome. They have a leader capable of summoning reinforcements. If we find and strike down that person, we can prevent further interruptions.
I'm guessing that's Kaspar and Lionheart. Alright. Fair enough. Alright, I don't need to know your ranges. I need to know your ranges though. Maybe sending Dimitri here alone was kinda ballsy. Not gonna lie. Actually, never mind. You guys do jack shit. Be gone!
It is done.
Kill every last one of them.
You'll regret this.
Had to be done.
Right, I can warp. Should I warp though, is the thing. The condition is to kill the commander, right? Yeah. Yeah, all these maps seem very cheesable with warp. Because they usually want you to kill the commanders. Mercy, can you kill this guy? No, you're too slow. Unfortunately. Alright, Kaspar. Let's see how much you have grown. 75 HP, that's not bad.
Did you have to kill a lot of your friends to get here? Because I'm gonna give this fight everything I've got!
Save me.
I'm growing. But at what cost?
At the cost of a bad growth rate. Alright, I think it's time to go in. I think it's high time to go in. Hello there. I heard you were shooting arrows.
Never let your guard down.
I don't double you. That kinda sucks. Petra, do you double this guy? You probably do. Yeah, good girl. Can you double with... Oh, oof. Silver X. I guess I can go for that.
You are in my way. Witness Bridget Pride.
Witness broken pride. Alright, so what battalion do you guys have? Oh, you have worthless battalion, okay. How about you come a little closer then?
It won't be in vain.
Alright, I think I did everything I could do this phase, so let's kill Caspar and the music. For now. I guess I'm gonna throw the grabbing machine. Get out of here, Casper. Put some
Don't
pants
worry
on.
About me. I always knew losing meant death.
I like your grown-up design, but you gotta go, man. Thanks for the breakbacks, though. I'll take good care of that. Should I bait the monster though? Probably not a good idea. Not with the Gradivus anyway. Although I can probably repair it, so maybe it's not that bad. Yeah, you know what? Come over here.
Useful.
Man, 25 damage on a barrier, that's pretty impressive.
Foolish. I swear it wasn't in vain.
What is this? D Dimitri got a level up with no strength? Who are you and what did you do with Dimitri?
I'll end this quickly. I aim for greatness.
Ooh.
Effort truly does pay off in the end.
Fight and avoidance.
I shall not stray.
It is done.
Hey, Lionheart. I heard you like to smash.
I'd rather not fight. Yet avoiding it is more frustrating and fruitless than engaging in the battle itself. I hope someday there will be no fighting and we can all just nap the afternoon away.
Don't worry, Lionheart. You can nap for all eternity now. Press F in the chat. Oh, this guy has Calibur, doesn't he? Oh, yes. Okay, I'm out of here. Wait, why am I getting hit by? Is there another ballista in here? Or this guy has Meteor, probably. No, you. Wait. What? How much movement do you. It's a long range Excalibur? What? Oh no, you have Meteor, never mind. Why does it say that you're attacking me with Excalibur? Oh no, wait, okay. Sorry, I'm looking at the wrong UI. I'm looking at the wrong UI, never mind. Alright, Lycia and you, you can kill this guy, I guess. Swarmsea? Yeah, Swarmsea.
I will not die yet. I'm not there yet.
Not there yet. Still not 50 magic. Yeah, he'll let you be able to tank that pretty well. Alright, what do I do against you though? Apparently. Oh, I can gambit from here actually. That works out for me.
I'm on it. There's our opening.
A threat eliminated.
Who has the other chess key? Oh, Hilda has it, doesn't she? God damn it, I should have sent Hilda this way. Oh well. I think I can break the last barrier with my character. He's gonna have one health left, but I can probably kill him pretty easily next turn. Hmm. Oh, that's a cool crit. Actually, Mercy, can you kill him? Maybe with a crit. Not quite. Oh, I still have Petra. Never mind, Petra can kill him. Easy. Easy. Oh, wait. Oops. I don't have a ranged weapon on her. I need to give her a ranged weapon.
To survive, I will win.
You make me feel safe.
Stop dropping rocks on me. That's not cool. Wait, they're still getting reinforcements, right? Okay then.
I can do no less.
I aim for greatness.
This guy is probably gonna move as soon as we get kinda close to him. We gotta watch out for that. Is that on meteor range? That's probably on meteor range too. No. Whose range is this? Is this too? Oh, okay. Never mind.
Luck wasn't with you.
Alright, so Hilda, I need to get you all the way around. Because, you have the chest key, so. Oh my god, Lexidia. Don't fall behind, please.
I shouldn't strain myself.
Actually, you probably should fortify here. Fortify is so good on Mercedes too, because she gets like all the hell back. Alright, Ingrid should be able to take care of the horses. And yeah, we need to get that chest. Maybe I can trade. Yeah, I can trade the key to Ingrid, and Ingrid can go get the chest. That way I can have Hilda for whatever shenanigans I want to do with her.
Hopefully I'll be more useful.
No, she lost the 69 HP. God damn it. We worked hard for that 69, man.
You took me lightly.
Alright, Hilda. Give me that key. This guy. It's a spear. He's probably gonna throw the spear at me. Alright. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to wait till Lyseria catches up with us, because I'm gonna kill the Dead Knight with her. Although, I guess Mercedes getting the kill wouldn't be bad either.
I swear it wasn't in vain.
Another victory. More fighting. Thank you.
Got 5 moments. I can probably let's try here. Yeah. Then I can dance for Lyseria so she can move again. Yeah, that seems like it will work.
Thank you.
Unless he decides to move now. I guess we'll see.
I'll end this quickly. I aim for greatness. Practice is paying off.
Oh, hi there.
On to the next battle.
I heard you guys like to magic. Oh, these are the leaders, okay. Makes sense, I guess. I wonder if this would have been other characters if I didn't recruit. Maybe one would have been Dorothea or something. Black Pearl. Oh. That's like whatever. Actually, we can technically end the map now if I wanted. If I wanted to. Let's see. You will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. Okay, yeah, you will make it. But I do wonder. Do you have a dialogue with her? You know what? Just for the sake of dialogue, I'm gonna die with Mercedes. She's gonna die. Straight up. But I want to see if she has a dialogue with him. And then I'm gonna rewind.
I have no need of you.
I guess not. I guess she doesn't.
I go now to meet the goddess.
Alright, I was curious about that.
At your service.
Thank you.
Alright, time to kill the Dead Knight.
More fighting. That helps.
We already got the treasure. Nobody else seems to have a treasure. Alright, Lyseria.
Let's make this quick.
Can you kill is the question now. That looks very dead to me. Alright, that works.
Let's clean up. Feels good to fight for a cause. What's my strategy?
What is my strategy?
I am prepared.
Can you kill this guy? Okay, perfect. My character can take care of the armored knight.
I'll cut a path for his highness.
T-pose on them, the dude. T-pose on them.
Allow me to demonstrate. Yeah!
This could turn the tides.
69.
Nice work.
Alright. You know, just because I'm a G, I'm gonna do it at close range. Sup, Dead Knight? Are we intimidating enough for you?
I have no need of you. To kill, to die, to know one without the other would be maddening.
The enemy general has been vanquished. Everyone, move to gain control of the keep. Victory is ours. Raise the banner of the knights. May it soar proudly over the impregnable fortress.
Easy. Easy money.
Your Highness, our capture of the fortress is complete.
Now the path to the Imperial Capital is finally open to us. Once we have finished cleaning up after the battle, let's have another meeting to discuss our next move. Naturally, but it matters not. Consider this. Once this war is over, the mountain of official business on my plate will be even taller. If I can't handle at least this much, how will I...
Pardon the interruption. We've just received a letter from Margrave Gautier.
Very well. I will read it at once. I see. It seems the conflict within Fargus has at last come to an end.
Yes, Your Highness. Margrave and the other Eastern Lords are at the center of it, and are gathering the Kingdom's military forces even now. They intend to join with the Alliance Army and send troops and supplies to the monastery.
What do you know? My old man is really pulling his weight. Did he seem well?
Yes, as well as can be expected. He has taken it upon himself to bring order back to our troubled territory, while His Highness is away.
I am truly in the Margrave's debt. I will be sure to thank him properly at first opportunity. Thank you for the information. Now tell me, did it seem to you that my presence was needed back at the monastery?
Well, I do have a verbal message from the Margrave on the subject.
A verbal message? How strange.
The other day, he arrested one of Viscount Clyman's men. And, well, the prisoner has claimed involvement in the tragedy of Dusker. He has implicated his lord as well.
Go on.
I was told they would be transporting this man to the monastery, along with the troops and supplies. The Margrave said that regardless of the credibility of the man's testimony, how he should be dealt with was your decision alone, Your Highness.
Very well. All that considered, I will return to the monastery at once. Will you come with me, Professor? Thank you.